Hello, dudes and dudettes. Welcome to the final, the Stanley Parable. Akhirnya kita nak tamatkan game ni. So, jom tadi main. Bro, memang mati sungguh kot. Terpaksa restart the game again lah tau. Restart the game again. Weh, jadi Eminem aku.
Like, oh, it was possible. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Jadi sekarang ni, kita dekat tempat ni pula.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
For her? Perempuan tadi.
Your chance to redeem yourself, to put your work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Siapa dia? Isteri aku ke bos aku? Woi, papang.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this, to reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Stanley, is that you? Hold on.
Yeah, it's me. I'm
just pulling the bread out of the oven.
Honey.
Oh.
Honey.
Okay, there we go. All right, now I want you to come in and tell me all about
your doom.
Gotcha. Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife? Who'd want to commit their life to you?
Sakit.
Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Dah lah sakit. Terkejut pula tu.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
Ay, aku hidup lagi lah.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
Lagi sakit.
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do.
Oh!
Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Tak mau. Buruk lim dia. Tak boleh juga.
But in his mind, in his mind he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him. And so
every night in my dreams, I see you, I feel you. That is how I know you. Go on.
Realize that all of his co-workers, his boss,
image aku rosak bro, sebab mamat ni eh.
Off the face of the earth, the thought excited him terribly.
The boys.
So he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold.
Huh?
As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable.
It was such a wonderful fantasy, and so in his head, he relived it again, and then again, and again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time.
I love you.
Every night in my dreams, I see you, I feel you.
Forever alone. He gets,
Istria Kuzmola Georgia.
Life is the real one. And I'm trying to tell him this, that in this world he can never be anything but an observer, that as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
You know what? You know what? Ain't nobody got time for that. Oh, hell no.
You see, can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself? I suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time he'll see. Maybe this time. And I tried again, and Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again, and Stanley pushed a button. And I tried.
Huh? What? What? Kanan ke kiri ya? Kanan ke kiri.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the first but eager to get back to business. Yet there was not a single person here either.
Huh? Just strategy, bunuh panda, okay? Bunuh panda nak majukan business.
The moment for another human life, for he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Oh, hell no!
Oh, Stanley, you didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control? Oh, Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go. Turn the controls off.
Kalau tekan off betul effect dia.
If you want my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex. How long until detonation then? Let's say 2 minutes. Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are.
A moment of solace before you're obliterated.
Dude, I've been too.
All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway.
Every night in my...
I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though. This version of events has been rather amusing.
Watching you try
to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not? These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room.
What?
These numbered buttons. No, these colored ones. Or maybe this big red button. Or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? One soul?
Oof.
Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is? Stanley, you're in for quite a disappointment. But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along.
What?
It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless. To see you made humble. This is not a challenge. It's a tragedy.
Tragedy.
To control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't.
Wait.
Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing.
Oh my god.
No ending here. Just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life? Or will you let it go peacefully?
I can see though.
It's all the same.
It's going black. I can see, bro. I can see, bros.
From the moment we fade in,
I'm dying. Oh. Boom! The happy that bro, the standing parable at kind of part 3 ni, the art here part. Oh, the art here part pak hang. Tengok English aku broken pak hang. Kenapa suka video ni, apa like, share dan comment jangan below apa pendapat anda. Dan terima kasih kepada apa yang stay tengok, follow aku semua video YouTube aku ni. So, sebab tu aku sayang apa. Okay dudes, see you guys.